Hey guys, it's Dan from Generation Productions, and this is episode three. This is episode three of my Fossil Hunt series, Fossil Hunter series, and I just want to show you some more of my fossils in my collection. And I want to do another thing about how to spot a fake, and also I've got some other special stuff scattered out through the thing. So, what we have is some of the stuff. But I want to say also an apology for the last video, episode 2. What happened was I had a fan going, and there was like dust going back and forth across the screen, and I reckon that was causing the camera to zoom in and out a lot, and it was causing the image to be blurry, so I do apologise for that. I hope this video won't be so blurry. So I'm going to try and do a bit of an overture about that, and also I'm going to do a little bit of an intro for you guys as well. Again, the music is being played by Rockstar7x. Go check out his channel. Yeah, he's got some really great rock music and stuff, so that would be absolutely brilliant for you guys to go check him out. And yeah, just people just go and check him out. And also, the music he's playing, the original Jurassic Park music was done by John Williams. So, let's get into it, shall we? Okay. Dan Guys, Fossil Hunters! So, let's get into it. GP, Dan Guys, Fossil Hunters. So, let's get into it. So, another part of the thing I have is the Mosasaur jawbone. This is, this is from the Cretaceous area. And it's supposed to be from a thing called Matrix, which is the type of rock. It was supposed to be from the Kouabinga region of Morocco. I don't know if I pronounced that right, but there we go. As you can see, it was very nicely done. You can see that both the top at the top and the lower jaw. It looks very, very absolutely amazing. I think it's absolutely brilliant. I absolutely love this little piece. So, that's that one. And we have also some other pieces as well. These two are the megalodon teeth. I don't know if they're both from the same area, but this other one here, this big one, he's from the Micronene Age, and is found in the Cooper River, and it was from South Carolina in the USA. Now, I don't know if this other one came from it either, but it's also a slightly different colour. So, I think it's actually from a different region. I don't have the actual other little readout piece for this one, but here we go. So that's the real megalodon teeth, and how I know these are real is because I can smell them. and they smell like sea salt. So that's how you know these are real, because they can actually smell like sea salt. But again, a little bit of a comparison, that's the replica. That's the one that actually had like some real shark teeth inside it. Best way to get them out of these kind of things is if you soak them in water. That's the best way to get out. Or if kids want to be really messy and stuff, you can get like a little hammer or a chisel and just crack it. But to be honest, I just like soaking them. But that's also the fake fossil. And the reason why I didn't want to break this open, because it looks so beautiful as it is. But this is how you can spot a fake. This is the real one. That's the fake. The coloration, as you can see, even though it looks a little bit similar, it's not. It's a lot more darker color, and it looks a little bit more like it's painted. This looks like more like it's been varnished. So that's how you sort of can tell the difference. Again, if I had the glad wrap off this, because it's like a wrap put on this thing. If I was to take that off, this thing would smell like plaster. This thing would smell like the sea salt, like I was saying before. So that's how you sort of can tell the difference between the real and the fake. And also, we have some fake. Speaking of fake fossils, I've got some ones I've made up again myself. Here's an ammonite. Basically, what I did was there's like a plaster cast, and I put the plaster cast down. And then I put a rock, as the plaster was setting, I put the rock on top, and it actually, then I painted it, and it actually looks like a real fossil. I mean, it looks really, really good, as you can, people can see. It absolutely looks brilliant. I've done that with a few more other ones as well. But there we go. That's another replica. And also another replica too. Well, some fossils, some things, there's like these little sticky raised stickers that you can actually buy from like op shops or cheapest chip top shops, or you know, basically I'm trying to think of what the American term would be, but like some of those dollar stores, you can pick up these little stickers, these raised stickers, and so I actually glued those little raised stickers onto a rock. And as you can see, with this trilobite one, it looks absolutely like it's realistic, but it's absolutely, it's fake. The stickers that you can stick on your bedroom wall, or door, or whatever, or on your, you know, books, or whatever. But I just thought it would just look so pretty cool. And as you guys can see, with these replica fakes I've made, they look really, really impressive, and they look absolutely amazing. So that's something for you guys to look into. And also another final thing was that my mum is a school teacher, so I made some of these things for the kids to do, some dinosaur stuff with. And that was this. This is a plaster cast, and I put a bit of shale in it. And the shale is from like shell grit. And I thought, oh, that's shell grit. It looks very much like some shells you'd find as the fossils. So there we go, people. That's what it is, the shell grit. Put in plaster. It makes this nice prehistoric-looking shell wall. I mean, it looks absolutely amazing. Well, to me it does, anyway. It looks like it really paid off. So people can, you know, make their own. That looks absolutely good. Just fill a ice cream container or a little container with a little bit of plaster and drop shells in, and then you've got yourself a nice little creek bed or river bed or sea bed with shells in it. Okay, now piece of the Grand Resistance, we have the final one. This fossil, it's a trilobite. Now I don't know where the the actual little label was that went, and I think it's actually got a little bit broken as well at the back here. I don't know how it got broken, but it just got a bit broken up, so I don't know how that happened. I really don't know how it got broken. And there's like other little abrasions and breaks. Well, so I don't know how that happened, But then again, that just goes to show it's a real fossil, because as time goes on, real fossils, if they're not looked after properly, which, yes, I do apologise to this poor little critter for not looking after him properly, but as if you don't look after fossils properly, they will start deteriorating and breaking up. So, yeah. And also, if I smell this, it smells like sea salt, and also a little bit it smells like another kind of stone as well, like graphite or something. It's got a unique smell to it. I think there's a little bit of iron and stuff in it too. Huh. I don't know if graphite has a bit of iron in it or not. But there we go. It looks absolutely beautiful. And, yeah. It just sucks that it broke up a little bit. But it still looks absolutely beautifully gorgeous. Absolutely love it. All these marks here are probably from, like, laser cutting to get it out, or chisels to actually try and chisel it out of the rock. But absolutely looks absolutely stunning. It's absolutely beautiful. I'm just really geeking over this trollobite. It looks absolutely beautiful. So that's the little bit of my fossil collection. But I do have two other little bits and pieces, which is basically a thing where I think what happened to the dinosaurs, and also another little tidbit about how to contact some people where you can buy some of these lovely fossils from. So stay tuned for that, for episode 4 and the other episode about what happened to the dinosaurs in my theory, and I believe it's absolutely true. That's just me. Anyone else can believe what they want to believe, but that's coming up as well. But so, thank you people for watching, stay tuned, and keep watching my videos. Thank you people for supporting my channel, and stay tuned. Okay, catch you later people, bye!